Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to day two.
Welcome to day two. Day two. This cruise is flying by.
Oh, not already.
It's already day two. How did that happen?
And our morning show, it's called Beyond Sunrise.
Well, we had, as many people know, that this cruise is called Venice and Beyond. Venice and Beyond. So we had a bit of a tiff before we started. And by the way, if you're watching this, well, there's maybe one or two people on the ship watching us. You're discovering that we have a morning show. This is Pete. Allow me to introduce Pete Klingon, our cruise host.
Hello, everyone.
Big round of applause. Oh, that's basically just me.
A round of applause.
Yeah.
But I'll take it.
Pete is my partner in crime. Not my partner, but my partner in crime.
Thanks for clarifying that.
In fact, how great is it that your wife and baby child, Coco, Colette, are on this ship?
Yeah, arrived yesterday in Venice, and it's the very first time that we've all sailed as a family. We've got a big history of cruising. My wife and I, we met on the Oosterdam, the sister ship of the Westerdam.
Right.
So, yeah, it's all on, and I was just so thrilled to see them yesterday and just have them experience, you know, I mean, what we got with that incredible day sailing out of Venice.
How about that as a gift?
Well, I think that's about as good as it gets, you know, and as far as sailaways anywhere in the world go, it was so special, you know, music pumping, blue skies, incredible, wasn't it?
It was absolute perfection. And I just want to say welcome to Juliet, welcome to Colette.
Thanks, mate. Yeah.
And welcome to you,
absolutely,
our beloved guests. And I'm overwhelmed because when I see all the faces, people coming from all over the world, traveling halfway around the globe just to be here for Venice and Beyond, it's inspiring, it's humbling, I can't describe the feeling, but when I feel it, it's all the little skin bumps come, and it's just, I can get very used to that. So thank you so much. If I said thank you from this point on till the end of day seven, it wouldn't be enough for being here. So we really appreciate you being here, not just showing up, but showing up like you did yesterday and last night. But let me get back to my original point. By the way, this is not a very professional show. We have no budget. We have no script. We have no plan. So
we've got nothing.
We've got absolutely nothing. But some people actually enjoy that.
They do. And I mean, our two viewers right now, I'm sure they're just probably sitting in bed with a cup of coffee or tea, just loving every second of this.
I can feel them clicking off right now, our two viewers. But anyway, we had a little bit of a tiff. We don't argue.
Not at all.
Do we?
Ever. No.
But we did have a little bit of an argument about the name of this show because I thought it should be called Sunrise and Beyond because, as you can see from the hat and from everything, all of our little logos, it says Venice and Beyond. So Sunrise and Beyond. But you...
Well, I just thought everything that we're really talking about happens beyond sunrise. So, you know, but look, I mean, that said, it's the Dave Koz cruise, so...
It's not the Pete Klingon cruise.
No, but that's a whole different story. I've got a dinghy somewhere that I'm taking out, you know, with my wife and daughter. They're the only two people that, and I had to actually pay for them to go on.
I would actually pay for a ticket on that one.
Well, yeah. Great. Well, there we go.
You wouldn't want me.
Oh, no, I would for sure.
But is it that important to you? Because, you know,
no,
I love you so much. I want you to be happy this week.
Oh,
so if it's
come on, I'm
beyond sunrise, I'm cool with it.
I'm just absolutely rapt to be here, and I think you're right. You know, looking back at Venice and Beyond, let's stick with Sunrise and Beyond.
Okay, settled. We got my way. Perfect.
I'm used to that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, well, listen, we just wanted to review some of the things that happened yesterday and last night, because what a perfect first day.
Oh,
as you mentioned,
incredible.
The sail away. I want to say a big thank you to Marcus Anderson, who joined Santorini Soul on the Sea View Pool aft deck for what was... you can't really go wrong when you're sailing through the Grand Canal.
Yeah.
I mean, it's...
I mean, I could be singing or playing saxophone, and I mean, people... They'd be a bit disturbed by that, but they'd still enjoy the sights.
They'd look beyond.
They would.
There's that word again.
but no, it was so special.
Yeah, Marcus, welcome to our cruise for the first time. Santorini Soul, who was with us as Caribbean Soul last year in the Caribbean, they are back. And we had so many wonderful first night shows as well. The tip of the iceberg, of course, was Jonathan and Gerald. Jonathan Butler and Gerald Albright doing their show, their duet show that they've done for the last year or so with some new surprises. And those two guys are just, they're pure magic.
Yeah.
And the minute that they take the stage, the grooves, the feel, when Jonathan sings, he opens up his mouth and it's just all is right in the world. And the same thing when Gerald plays that alto saxophone. It's just pure perfection.
And you'd spoke for, you know, months now of, you know, trying to have the right mix for the first night, you know, our first night main stage show, and you know, you thought sailing out of Venice, we need something incredibly special, and that's exactly what we got last night.
Well, also, we understand that many of our guests have traveled from long ways away and maybe a little bit jet lagged, and so we wanted a show on the first night that really had the energy to spark the energy of this ship. And I feel it. I feel it the second day here. I'm really excited to see everybody at our autograph sessions.
Yep.
It's happening a little later this morning. And so the energy is here, and I think it's going to ride us all the way for the next 7 days.
That's for sure. And I wanted to give a quick shout out as well to a show that I caught last night, which was introducing Aubrey Logan. This was the first time I got to experience the talents of Aubrey, and I was just absolutely blown away.
Aubrey is someone that I found out about from being a fan of Postmodern Jukebox, which is kind of an internet YouTube sensation. It's a group that is made up of very young people that are doing almost like 1920s, 1930s arrangements of popular tunes of the day, of now, but done in a very old style. And Aubrey, pardon me, Aubrey is just an incredible talent. She's got this 8-octave range as a vocalist, but then she plays the trombone.
Right.
I mean, what are the chances of that happening?
Well,
do you play the trombone?
I don't, no, but I don't have probably a 1-octave range, so there's no surprise there. But no, look, I mean, the chances wouldn't be good, I'd expect. But yeah, I mean, what a great talent. I just enjoyed it so much, you know, last night on day one. And I think coming up maybe today, or that could be our two guests calling in.
That's our one viewer telling us to shut up.
I think we'll coming up shortly anyway. We do have an event with Aubrey playing the trombone.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, me and my trombone. I think that happens. I think it's on day three. No, I'm not sure. Yeah, it's on day three.
Great.
Hard to keep it all straight. You know that we have planned over 150 events over the next week. And if there's one thing that I hear from our guests over and over, is that there's too much. But that's by design. We want to give you more options than you can actually do, because we hope that you come back and that you can also sample things. You can stay for a little bit of this show and then leave and go catch another show. There's so much talent. And as we found out yesterday at the Sail Away, we've never had this many surprise special guests.
Oh, yeah.
And so I want to say a big thank you to all of them. That's Peter White, who, by the way, did a beautiful job in the Peter White's pub last night.
I wonder if he'll leave this week. You know, like on previous cruises, he just sits there the entire time.
Well, all you need to do is buy him a beer, and he's very happy. He'll play all night. Peter White's pub last night was great. So he's a surprise guest. Michael Linkton, a surprise guest, and Michael is going to be doing some great shows this week and popping up everywhere. We had Kenny Lattimore as a surprise guest.
Oh, well, the ladies happy to see Kenny.
Oh. That was when I announced his name.
Woo! Yeah.
That was powerful. Mindy Hebert is a surprise guest, and I don't like cruising without Mindy.
Neither do I. Yeah, I love Mindy. She's such a great woman and just so much fun, you know. She really brings the energy and you know, she's the essence of what we're trying to do here on the Dave Koz Cruise, bring everyone together and just have a great time.
And she has her own unique style. That's what you can really say about Mindy. When she plays, when her music is just completely her. And finally, we have music royalty on this ship. And I'm so blown away. She said yes when I called her and I said, please come, please do a show. When Al Jarreau sadly passed, it left a gaping hole in our schedule. And we were all very stunned. We were all very sad. And that's when I started getting calls from friends. And Mindy called me and said, if you need me, I'm there. It was so beautiful, the outpouring of support from our artist community. Because we all loved Al. We loved and appreciated him so much. And I can tell you that you should look forward to Night 7 when we celebrate the legacy of Al Jarreau in music, in stories, in videos. It's going to be a very, very special show. But one of the people that I talked to when Al passed was a great friend of Al, and she offered her services to come on and entertain us. And that is the great Valerie Simpson.
Oh, yeah.
So
it's going to be very, very special.
Val, I love you. And she brought her two daughters with her on this trip, Asia and Nicole. And I know that we're going to have a fantastic time. And Valerie and Kenny will be doing Night 7 show after the Al Jarreau tribute.
Yeah,
so it's
perfect.
Pretty special. Very, very special. Lots of music. This is the best lineup I think for me, this is the best lineup of artists that we've ever had in the 11 years of cruising that I've done.
And the great news, as you said, we've got so many events, and not everyone can get to all of them. But these artists, you know, they're playing a lot through the week.
Right.
So, you know, as you say, you can get into one and then maybe you have to sacrifice one for something else you want to see. But right. they're, you know, we've got these guys and girls playing everywhere. So it's going to be fantastic fun all week long.
One of the people who I'm very excited to have back on our cruise is the incomparable Rick Braun.
Yeah.
Rick Braun is one of my best friends, and nobody plays the trumpet quite like him. And he is back, and his kids are on this week, Emma and
fantastic.
Kyle. Hello, Emma and Kyle, and his lovely wife, Christiane. And so very, very excited to welcome Rick back. Last night, he hosted Rick's Cafe, which
yeah.
is in the Ocean Bar.
That's right.
And he'll have a few programs that are going to be happening at Rick's Cafe. He called me, and he was a little, you know, filthy, to use one of your words. He says, well, why does Peter White get the Peter White pub?
Was he really?
Yeah. Why can't I have a place? I said, well, what do you want to do? And he said, well, what about Rick's Cafe? You know, kind of like Casablanca.
Yeah, yeah.
I said, done. But that means you have to actually be there.
And look, both events in there last night were just fantastic. You know, Vincent Ingala, who's been on every single one of our cruises
right.
Since 2011 in Alaska, you know, such a great talent. And then the Great American Songbook as well. Just
yeah.
Two great events.
That was special.
And, yeah.
I love that event. I mean, the music, how can you go wrong? And I love popping up there. And that's what this whole cruise is about, is artists supporting each other. The word collaboration comes to mind, because that really is what music is all about, is collaborating.
Yep.
And you have a bunch of artists on this ship that are true friends, that love each other and support each other. Sheila E. came up the other night to me and said, you know, it's very rare for us as musicians to have an opportunity to not only play together, but also to support each other and encourage each other. And you'll see at many of the shows, if somebody's on stage, you'll see other artists in the audience kind of like really grooving, because we never get a chance to do that. We're always busy doing our own shows and being on the road and traveling.
Yeah.
So this way, this week is a really special week, because we get to be fans of our friends. And just like you, you're fans of the music, and so are we.
Well, I think that's the great common denominator of this cruise is, you know, all of us here, we're all here because we love the music.
And there's no strangers on this ship, as we found out yesterday at the Sail Away.
Yeah.
Once you step foot on the Westerdam, and by the way, how great
is this ship? Oh, it looks fantastic, doesn't it? Yeah, it's beautiful.
Many of our cruisers have been on this ship before, because I hosted, I think, three or four cruises on the Westerdam.
Yep.
But it looked very different. It just came out of dry dock. It's been completely refurbished. And a big shout out to Mark Pels and his wonderful staff, and Captain Mark and his wonderful staff, for giving us this home for 7 days that is truly beautiful.
Yeah, great place, that's for sure.
Yeah.
All right, so should we have a look at the events that we've got going on today?
Can I just also make a quick note about two newcomers to our cruise? To our cruise, not newcomers to music, but to our cruise for the first time, Paul Jackson Jr. and Patrice Rushen. If you take the two of them out of the mix of modern music, you want to talk about like huge holes. Because Paul Jackson, he corrected me, because I said somewhere publicly, maybe even on one of the bios, I said he's played on over 1,000 recordings. And he stopped me in the hallway the other day, and he said, I don't want to nitpick, but it's actually over 2,000.
Wow.
And I'm not just talking about like records that nobody's heard of. I'm talking about, you know, Michael Jackson records and Barbara Streisand, and, you know, the list goes on and on of the musical heavyweights. And Patrice Rushen too. She's been at it for decades, and she's now the dean of music for USC at USC's Thornton School of Music. So she's taken time out of her professorship to be here with us. So I just want to say thank you to those guys. And they both did a fantastic show last night in the Queen's Lounge. And by the way, the Queen's Lounge out of dry dock. It's a little confusion here, because it's not really called the Queen's Lounge, right?
Right, yeah. So the Westerdam's just been through a refurbishment, folks. And the Queen's Lounge is now called B.B. King's Blues Club. We have some signage actually on a digital board outside the Queen's Lounge that says the Queen's Lounge with the Dave Cozzen Friends at Sea logo. But it's all you need to know really is it's midship on deck number 2, and it's one of the same. Queen's Lounge or the BB King's Blues Club, it's all the same place.
Okay, we'll clear that up. All right, let's talk about today.
Yeah.
Day two on the Westerdam.
So firstly, of course, we're going to have, you mentioned our autograph signings where you get to meet all of the artists and musicians, maybe get a poster signed or a CD or your souvenir book. But there is one quick change that I do need to tell you about, and then that is we have swapped the captain from the ocean bar into the gallery bar, and the artists which were in the gallery bar we've taken up to the ocean bar. So that's Peter White, Richard Elliott, Michael Linkton, it's our comedian Ron Pearson, and someone else as well, I think.
You get back to us.
We'll get back to you on that, but yeah, it's a bunch of people. So anyway, from your souvenir booklet, we are just swapping the captain and the artists that are in the gallery bar.
So that happens from 9 to 11 a.m., and then we are cruising into Croatia. Today we get to go to our very first port of call, which is Dubrovnik, Croatia. I'm sorry. And this is a beautiful medieval city. It's a walled city. For those of you who are Game of Thrones fans, you know this because it's used as the backdrop for a lot of the scenes in that show. And it's just kind of a magical place. It's a beautiful, beautiful city. And it feels like Dubrovnik and Kotor, where we will be tomorrow, these are cities that are relatively untouched. I mean, they're civilizations, of course. They've been around for hundreds and hundreds of years. But it feels like they're a little bit undiscovered. You know, they're not yet tainted by the mass tourism that say, like a Paris or London has.
No, absolutely. And I mean, this is just such a special part of the world here. They call it the Pearl of the Adriatic, Dubrovnik. So when you're there, I mean, you know, so special, in fact, that wait till you see the shimmer off the sea from the sun. It's different than, I mean, I've cruised, you know, most of my professional life, and it's just different than anywhere else. Mm-hmm. That's a special part. And you go out and explore the town, the old city, the marble streets. It's just magnificent.
It's actually a very easy city to navigate through because it's kind of small. What would you recommend to people who just want, I mean, I know we have a lot of excursions, people are doing a lot of different things, but if you're just getting off the ship and exploring on your own, what would you recommend?
I'd recommend, you know, for me, just some lunch and just, you know, a bit of exploration of the old town. You know, check out the marble streets, just try and soak up the atmosphere, and then before you come back on board, have a swim in the Adriatic. You know, it's just magic. Yeah, the water is absolutely beautiful. So that's what I'll be doing today.
When my first visit to Dubrovnik, I bought a ticket. It's a few euro, and you can walk the steps, a little bit of a hike up the steps, but then you can actually walk the perimeter wall of the entire city. You don't have to do the whole wall, you can kind of get down at various places, but if you do, it takes maybe about an hour and a half or something like that, but you can actually see the city from the wall, which is really a beautiful perspective.
Spectacular.
All the terracotta roofs, it's really special, and you can see the sea right there. I hope that you have a fantastic day in Dubrovnik.
And you do need to remember as well, folks, when you are going shoreside today, please take your cruise card with you. It's the same as your stateroom key, so hopefully you've got that on you anyway. And also a photo ID, a government-issued photo ID you're going to need to carry. If you are on a shore excursion, just refer to the ticket for when and where you need to meet to successfully meet your tour today.
And we arrive about noon into Dubrovnik. So, but before all of that happens, we have a Vincent Ingala show with the UK Collective, our buddies from London. That's Ollie Silk, Frank Felix, Mark Parnell, and Mark James, who are phenomenal musicians. And Vincent has a great relationship with them. They're going to be doing a show at the Sea View Pool from 11:30 to 12:30. So you can actually watch the Westerdam pull into Dubrovnik while listening to those guys play some music. So that sounds good to me.
And just taking a look outside, it looks like we've got some fantastic weather. So it's going to be great, you know, being out there with Vincent doing his thing today with the UK guys. And then later on this afternoon, Jay Gore and Mark James from the UK Collective, we've got a guitar duel, and this is going to be the US versus the UK.
Right.
And that's going to happen in the Ocean Bar on deck number 3.
Jay Gore, one of our main stage musicians from the US, Mark James, part of the UK Collective from London, and we'll see who wins.
Yeah. Who's your money on?
Well, I'm American. But Mark James is pretty good.
Yeah.
We'll find out.
I hope
they have flags. I asked for flags.
Yeah, we got flags, yeah.
You got flags?
We got flags. They're going to be up there.
The Union Jack and the American flag.
The Stars and Stripes.
Yeah. Pretty good for an Aussie.
Thanks, mate. Thanks.
In case you didn't know, some people are confused, but Pete is from Australia.
Who's confused?
Just clearing that up, in case you were wondering. All right, when we get back on board today, actually, we're in port till 11 p.m. This is a rare thing for our cruise. I don't think that we've ever had a cruise where we're in port for dinner time. So if you choose to stay in Dubrovnik for dinner, that is your prerogative, and we support you. But if you do choose to come back, boy, do we have some great entertainment for you tonight.
Spargatini at Sea, your great friends, Laurie Cisneros, is on board.
Yeah, that's right.
Hosting Gerald Albright, Just Between Us. We're going to have some drinks with Gerald in the Pinnacle Bar on deck number two. And then Greg Manning, Switzerland's own Greg Manning, with some sugar and spice. And that is Billboard on board, just on deck two, as opposite the casino there. It's a fantastic venue.
It really is.
We've got great stuff happening all week long.
And Greg Manning, also one of our main stage performers, playing keyboards, but over the last couple of years has really established himself as a wonderful solo artist. So he'll be playing music from his solo projects, Sugar and Spice. Patrick Bradley, great friend of ours, with a music and a style completely unique and totally his own. He'll be doing a show in the Ocean Bar at 8 o'clock for an hour. And then tonight, our headliners. Talk about a great show. Rick Braun and Richard Elliott. How about that? R&R.
I'm looking forward to this, let me tell you. And the great news about this as well, folks, because of the late sale, we are actually pushing tonight's shows back a little bit. So the first show for our guests with the Silver Cruise cards is going to happen at 8 p.m., and then our second show for our guests with the Gold Cruise cards is going to be 10:30. So if you do want to have a bite to eat in Dubrovnik and then come back on, we're allowing you to do that just by pushing these shows a little bit back tonight.
From a musical perspective, too, that relationship between a trumpet and a saxophone, a tenor saxophone to be specific, is a very special relationship. But you can't just put any trumpet player and any tenor sax player together and create that sound. But what Rick and Richard have, first of all, they're great friends, and their wives are great friends, and their families are great friends. And so when you approach the music like that, from a point of friendship and that kind of collaboration, you get this sound that is undeniable. And Rick and Richard, when you talk about that sound, trumpet and tenor saxophone, it's like this. It's not like this, it's like this. Yeah. They meet in the middle somewhere. And it's undeniable. So be sure to check out R&R tonight. Two huge shows, 8 p.m. and then again at 10:30 p.m.
That's right. And then the LA Collective featuring Letitia B. Valentine, who's one of our singers on board and a great lady.
Awesome singer, by the way.
And that's going to be upstairs in the Crow's Nest on deck number 10 forward.
We have a welcome back on board dance party if you want to get your dancing shoes on. That's going to be at the Sea View Pool aft on deck 9. That's going to be happening at
9 o'clock.
9 o'clock, yeah.
And then one event that I'm really looking forward to, just because I love this music so much, and we've got a bit of a special surprise for our guests as well, but two guys who we had come on with us for the first time last year in the Caribbean, Justin Hopkins and Dylan Chambers, just two great young guys, incredibly talented. They are actually going to become Hall & Oates, I believe, tonight.
Not just musically either. They've got the whole getup and all the shtick to match. And they're very excited. They pulled me aside and they said, "We're taking this very seriously." Those guys are great. Dylan and Justin. So if you don't have time to check them out tonight, be sure to check out their shows all week long. They're all over the place.
And then, of course, a guy who did a great show last night and is back on tonight is your mate and the winner of season one of The Voice, Javier Colon.
Huge Javier fan on this ship.
Oh, yeah. I think it's impossible
and I'm
not
one
to
of
be.
Them. I'm one
it's
of
impossible
them.
Not to be a big fan.
He just sings like an angel, and he's got so much power and conviction in his voice. And when he plays, he doesn't need a band. He just, you know, plays with him and his guitar. And it's like, it sounds like an orchestra. So he'll be playing songs from his album, Gravity, which is his last studio album, Billboard on board tonight at 9:30. And then a very exciting evening of entertainment at the Sea View Pool before we leave. That is going to be the Old School Cool Dance Party with Marcus Anderson and Santorini Soul. Coming back and doing it all over again as we push off from Dubrovnik.
And then our DK After Dark theme night is Croatian Cool, and it's been a pretty cool day so far. So this is working out pretty well for us. But the Dubrovnik Dance-Off Sea View Pool with Candy Dolfer, and Candy's going to play up there as well.
She's very excited because she's got these, she showed me the shoes, like the 70s shoes. I don't even know what you call them, but they're kind of like cork on the bottom. Do you know what
like
I'm talking
about?
The
heel, you mean?
Yeah, the heel is cork.
I mean, I haven't worn a pair of shoes like that for 2 weeks at least.
I just remember in the 70s growing up, my sister had a bunch of pairs of shoes just like
okay.
that. And I don't know where Candy found them, but they're like super retro cool. And so she's excited. Santorini Soul has got all their costumes. They're going to recreate the 70s musically for us. That's going to be really fun. That's 11 o'clock till late at the Seaview Pool, Deck 9. Singers and Songs. This is a great event that we're very, very excited to share with you. John Stoddart, a fantastic singer and keyboard player, musical director for Kirk Whalum. He's also our musical director for our gospel show,
gospel
which will be
show,
on our first day at sea in a couple of days. John Stoddart will assemble all the singers from our cruise in a very informal kind of mix of music and conversation to get behind the scenes of what it takes to be a singer. And, you know, for those of us who play instruments, we have this thing in front of us that sort of gives us a little crutch, if you will, because it's a vehicle by which we express ourselves.
Okay,
right?
I understand.
So there's something between the audience and us. There's
right.
this physical thing, right? A saxophone or trumpet. But when you're a vocalist, there's nothing there. So you open your mouth up and it's complete vulnerability. That's why I have so much profound respect for singers.
Yeah.
Because they're just, when they open their mouths, they're naked. They're completely naked. So we'll get into the process, like what it really takes to have a career as a singer, and John will walk us through that. Singers and Songs tonight, and that's at 11 o'clock in the Ocean Bar.
And then Ollie Silk, the razor-sharp Brit from the UK Collective, great keyboard player, fantastic guy. He's doing some great shows this week as well. And actually, funnily enough, when I introduce Ollie quite a bit on the cruise and last night, you know, did the intro for the UK guys.
Yeah.
And I said, you know, this guy is like the 2006, you know, smooth jazz new artist of the year. And, you know, the other guys had a bit of a crack at him about that, you know, the English guys. And then he said, I don't want to be introduced like that anymore. I want to be introduced as the most handsome man on this ship.
Are you going to do it?
Well, I'm going to, yeah, I mean, do I have a choice?
No.
You know?
It depends on how much he pays you.
Well, I'm going to try and get something out of it.
You should get at least €5 for
that. Yeah, yeah, no, definitely.
Each time you introduce him
yeah,
and
right.
share it with me.
Please. I will. We'll split it up. And then the comedy genius of Ron Pearson in the Queen's Lounge. And this guy, I mean, he's had a huge career already. Ron, Comedy Channel, The Late Late Show, Chelsea Handler, a bunch of Hollywood blockbuster movies. And, I mean, you know, the great thing about Ron is, I don't know if our guests are familiar with him yet, you will be soon, but just how talented this guy is. I mean, his comedy is one aspect of his career, but he's got so many other strings to his bow as well.
Strings to his bow.
Yeah.
Well, he's a juggler, first and foremost.
World champion juggler.
World champion. Did you check that?
I did.
Okay.
Yeah.
Other than with him?
Yeah, I did, because he told me that, and I said, well, it's not very often that I'm in the presence of a world champion, so I want to make sure that, you know, this is legit.
But so it's legit.
It's true. Yeah, yeah.
Okay, good. Wow. World champion juggler. He also rides a unicycle. He, when we came to Venice at the airport, we happened to come in at the same time, and I saw his anvil case. I said, I didn't know you were a musician. I thought it was like a guitar or a bass or something. He said, no, that's my unicycle. He's the only person on the ship with a unicycle, I'm pretty sure. I haven't checked every cabin, but I'm pretty sure that he's the only one.
I think it's a pretty safe bet to say that he is.
That's going to be a lot of fun. That's in the Queen's Lounge or B.B. King's Blues Club at 11:30 p.m. And then this is the penultimate show of the night, and I know it's going to be a fantastic one as we salute the legendary George Duke. There's a lot of artists on this ship that work very closely with George.
Yep.
Jonathan Butler, who will be hosting the event, Jeffrey Osborne, Kenny Lattimore, Paul Jackson Jr., the list goes on and on. George Duke had a tremendous hand in the careers of so many artists, and I think above and beyond his artistry and his incredible contribution, he was probably known and loved for being a cheerleader of other artists more than anything else.
Yeah.
He was such one of these kind of like just dads, you know. He delighted so much when in other people's success and nurturing talent. And so we want to celebrate George Duke musically tonight. All the artists who work with him, I got a chance to work with him, and I loved him very, very much. I do want to apologize. We have a little typo in our program that said Dookie Stick. We misspelled, they misspelled Duke. I blame you. They misspelled Dookie. It should be D-U-K-I-E. So apologize for that.
Well, I'll apologize. Oh, okay. You've just blamed me.
Yes.
And on, you know, to our viewers.
But I'm sure George would understand.
And he would, and that's what I wanted to say about George as well. I mean, I met him doing some cruises with him many, many years ago, and you know, you're sort of a bit in awe of the guy, you know, because he's a legend. He's the legend, George Duke. And I just remember him always being, you know, away from the musical side of things, just, and Corinne as well, his wife, just such an absolutely incredibly, you know, beautiful people.
Genuine.
Yeah, absolutely.
Genuine, yeah. Real, fun, always a big smile on his face. So it's going to be a very special night. That's going to happen in the Crow's Nest, 11:30 p.m. I shall be there for sure.
I'll be there.
I'm excited. We're doing, Paul Jackson Jr. and I are going to do a duet.
Okay, great. And looking forward to
that. So anyway, that's our day ahead. It's a jam-packed day, too. Hope you have a wonderful time. Should we do a couple of these, too? We have
absolutely
a lot of people celebrating on this ship.
That's for sure. First off, Leslie Coates celebrating a birthday. Happy birthday to you, Leslie, and it's great to have you on board.
Happy birthday, Leslie. Deborah Bennett is celebrating her retirement, and my significant other is a stroke patient survivor.
They're
that
two great
is
ones.
Awesome.
Andrew Clark, his 56th birthday. Happy birthday to you, Andrew. Have a great
birthday.
Week, mate.
And also to Allison Scale, celebrating her birthday on the ship. Congratulations.
Wendy Taft, celebrating an anniversary with Mr. Taft.
I would imagine.
I'm guessing. Yeah.
Franco Batiste is celebrating first year anniversary.
Wow.
So happy number one to the Batistes.
Paul Bastard, I think it is celebrating a birthday, cabin 10022. Happy birthday to you, Paul.
And we want to wish the Powell family a wonderful cruise ahead. Lannis, Paul, I'm hoping I'm pronouncing the name correctly. Lanny's retirement is celebrating for the Powell family. Way to go.
And Robert Lanacone celebrating his 70th birthday on board. So what a great great time to celebrate, Robert. Enjoy number 70.
Thank you so much for all, whatever it is that you are celebrating. You could just be here celebrating life. That's the most important thing. And I applaud you. As I said at the Sail Away, I applaud our guests just for taking that big bite out of life just by being here. You know, you could be anywhere, and the fact that you've chosen our cruise to spend your vacation, and of course the money that you spent to be here, but also your time, the fact that you're here and entrusting us with the gift of your time means the world to us, and we want to over deliver for these next 7 days to you to give you an unforgettable experience. So again, from Pete and I and our entire staff, we say thank you so much. We are pumped up with gratitude to you. I think that's the captain. For now, we say over and out. Have
goodbye.
A great day in Dubrovnik.
Enjoy Dubrovnik.